Hey everyone, welcome to Zellij. In this basic usage tutorial, I'm going to demonstrate some of the basic capabilities of the app, and then, as a demonstration, I'm going to tie it into my personal workflow to show you how I work with the app. You can, of course, adapt it to your own workflow, be it developing in the terminal or whatever else it is you do in the terminal. So right at the beginning, we open Zellij and we are greeted with a terminal pane. We can do all the terminal things that we want in it. On the top, we have the tab bar. Right now, we just have one tab open, and the session name, which is a human readable randomly generated name. On the bottom, we have the key hints showing us the modes that we can get into. And on the right, we have like kind of the immediate alt actions that we can do right now without entering a mode. So I'm going to start by opening one of the source files of Zellij. And here I'm going to insert some gibberish so that we get a compilation error. Now I'm about to open a new pane in order to run the tests and see if they catch this compilation error. So to do this, I'm going to press Alt N, as we see here on the bottom, to open a new pane wherever. When we press Alt N, Zellij kind of decides the best place to open the pane as it sees fit. Right now, it split our pane to the right and opened our pane here. We can also explicitly tell Zellij where to open a pane. If I do Control P to enter pane mode here on the bottom, then we see all the actions that we can perform in pane mode. I'm going to press D here to split down. And once I do, Zellij split down. If I do the same thing with Control P R to split right, Zellij split right. Now I'm going to close this extra pane with Control P and then X. Here we see X to close. And I want to briefly show you something else, because Zellij also has a unique capability to open panes as stacked. I can open a new pane as stacked upon the current pane with Control P and then S. And here we see we have two panes. I move through them with Alt and arrow keys. Here we see. I'll open a few more here so we can see it more clearly. So let's close all of these panes now. And as promised, I'm going to run the tests with cargo x test. This can take a while, and I kind of want to do things as this is happening. So I'm going to close this pane here with Control P X, and then I'm going to open it as stacked upon this pane. So now I'm going to do cargo X test, and then I can kind of flip through the two. I can go above, see the source code, and go below and see the pane. I see their titles above, which tell me what they are doing. Now I'm going to open a new stacked pane with Control P S to do something like kind of as I'm waiting for the test to run. Here I'll do like, let's say, a git diff and kind of page through the changes. As you see here, I added a log file, a log instruction rather, to log to the log file. So let's check out the log file. I'm going to open the log file in a floating pane. So we can open a floating pane by showing the floating pane surface. Here we have Alt plus F to open the floating pane. So we do that, and it opens a new terminal for us as floating. This is a normal terminal. We can do whatever we want with it. We can move it around with the mouse. We can even open new panes, new floating panes. I'm going to close them with Control PX so we can concentrate on this pane. And here I want to show you, if I press Alt F again, this pane will be sent into the background. So I can get back to my git diff, but let's bring it back again with Alt F, and we see that it's persistent. This floating pane is persistent per the tab that we are in. It saves its status. We can run programs here in the background and get back to them. But right now I'm going to fail the log files as promised. And here we see the log that I added every second as we serialize. I'm going to move this pane here to the right. I could also do this with a keyboard with Control H to enter move mode, and then with the arrows or HJKL to move it around. Then I'm going to do Alt F, but right now, like, it kind of disappeared. So like it went into the background, and we kind of want to see the logs like moving as we are working. So let's do Alt F again to bring the pane back. And now I'm going to pin it. Here we see pin on the right. I'm going to click here to add the plus. And then when I do Alt F to move back to the surface, it remains always on top. I can of course also pin it with the keyboard with Control PI. So now I guess the tests have finished running by now. Yes, they have. I moved back to the focus with Alt and up arrow. And now we see that indeed the tests caught our compilation error. Amazing. So now I kind of want to concentrate on these two panes, on the like the test pane here and the source code pane here. So I'm going to select both of them with multiple select. I'm doing this with a mouse, but we can also do this with a keyboard. So with a mouse, I'm doing Alt left mouse click. And here popped up the multiple select mode. Zellij tells us we have one selected pane and we can perform actions upon it. Let's also select our source code pane with Alt click. Now we have two panes. And now I'm going to press B in order to break them out to a new tab. So I press B, and here we are. We have our two panes here. We have here, like it said that we're in tab 2, and previously we're in tab 1. We can page through the tabs with the mouse, or of course with the keyboard as well in tab mode. And now I'm going to give this tab a new name to make it like kind of distinguishable. I'm going to do Control T to enter tab mode. And then I'm going to do R to rename this tab. So I'm doing R, let's call it Fix Tests. And now we are in the Fix Tests tab. And I'm going to do just that to delete my gibberish from before and save the file. And then I'm going to do Alt right arrow to move to the pane on the right, and here I'm going to run cargo x tests to once again run the tests, which should pass now. There are lots more features to this application. We're really just scratching the surface here, showing like just the basics. If you want to learn more, you can check out the rest of the screencast's tutorials below. Or you can just explore the app. It's self-explanatory. The UI, as you see, explains itself and shows you what you can do. Finally, I want to end with a personal request. I spend all of my time working on and developing Zellij. So if you like the application, if you like the work that I do and would like to see me continue doing it, please consider a recurring monthly donation to help me pay my bills. However much you can afford, even if it's just $5 to $10 a month, it will really help. Link below. And thank you so much for watching. I hope you enjoy Zellij responsibly. Bye-bye.